Millions of dollars worth of monies went into that organization. Right. Some $4 million worth of operational budget, some $3 million worth of state and federal grant money's gone in there.
And they've influenced policy.
Influenced policy, made changes, how we handle land sales and things of that nature has all been out there. And ladies and gentlemen, I want you to learn from this, and I want you to become a part and take an interest in this, because if you don't watch your government, if it goes unchecked, they will do whatever they want to. And I'm sure most of you agree the federal government is way past. But you know what? I can't have an effect on the federal right. government. I don't have the horsepower.
Right.
At the county level, I have a little horsepower. And hopefully, in 67 counties in the state of Florida and every other county in the United States of America and the parishes in Louisiana, there are concerned citizens that will take the same steps. Certainly, we're the only news organization that will cover all of this. I mean, for goodness sakes, the Pensacola News Journal was at this meeting, and they decided that their pick of stories from that meeting was, we're going to have a nature study group in Navarre.
Right.
They don't see the importance of this, and you know that's for them to work out. But We are the only group we are the only news gathering agency that's covering all this, ladies and gentlemen. You stick with us, and I think you're going to learn a lot, and we're going to do our best to make sure government does its part. So, Deborah, I'll tell you, I'm not happy that it had to come to the lengths that it took to get here. I'm an eternal optimist. I always believe that my government will do the right thing. Obviously, in this case, it took 4.5 years of prodding and...
Let's explain. What's been happening is that we've complained to Team Santa Rosa, and we've been ignored.
Right.
And then we've complained to the county commission, and we've been told, well, you have to deal with Team Santa Rosa. They've got nothing to do with us.
Right. They're a separate entity.
Even though several million dollars out of our pockets have passed right. through the county commission to Team Santa Rosa.
Even though the commission allocates funds to them
right.
every year out of the general fund.
They've been an integral part of county decision making, policy making, I'm talking about, for at least 4 years that I've been covering them.
Right.
And yet when we go to ask for help from our representatives in making them comply with the law, we're told, well, they've got nothing to do with us. You have to...
Well,
it's a runaround.
Yeah, it's been a catch-22.
Yes.
If you ask the county for help, no, they're a separate entity.
Right.
If you go to team, they say we're a private organization. Get out of here.
Right.
You know what? Well, you can't ask us to do this.
And let's go ahead and mention that when we went to team recently, and we were asked, "What do you want?" and we said we want meetings open to the public, as prescribed by Florida law. The comment that was made was, I guess we'll have to get the lawyers involved.
Yeah. Which really shocked me. And I think you'll remember my response is it is against my nature to spend money out of my pocket for an attorney to force my government to do what it is bound by law to do.
Right.
So, I'm somewhat satisfied. The official response is out there. Now, of note, it hadn't been put to a specific county commission meeting.
Right.
One of the next clips you're going to watch is, and we want to point out something to you that, and we've always felt it kind of odd, that Commissioner Salter has been the economic development representative off the commission for 8 years. Every year, no other commissioner got inside that organization. No other commissioner was invited inside that organization. This is the first time that anyone other than Salter has been involved in economic development. And I tell you,
Even when he wasn't chair, when he was commission chair before, when he wasn't chair, he was still involved with it.
Right.
We saw him involved with base issues and stuff like that.
But you know, and I think. you know, as I went forward and read the many Supreme Court cases and laid it out to them and asked them, did you notice how quick that Commissioner Salter said, oh, we'll, since Gordon Gooden is the economic chairman, we'll hand that off to him.
He passed it right over.
Ooh, it didn't take him long. You know, the potato got a little too hot,
I guess.
That
was a hot potato.
I think the thing that kind of surprised me, I was actually shocked that anybody responded.
Mm-hmm.
I guess the recipient of the Democracy Award for this week is going to go to Commissioner Bob Cole. Deborah, you've been there many times that I've asked a question and you could hear the crickets in the background. Nobody would answer. And Bob Cole, my hat's off to you. You took the bull by the horns. You did what any thinking person would have done. You understand the responsibility of being a commissioner. You said, you know what, we better ask the county attorney what kind of situation we might be getting into here. And, of course, I can tell you, I'm glad it went the way it did. I can assure you, even though I had taken my seat back in the back row, had there not been a matter of fact, let me read it again to the folks, and you're going to see this on a tape. I would like to hear each of your opinions on open meetings concerning team. Let me assure you that if there hadn't have been some kind of conversation, I was going back to the podium again, because I made a vow in 2000. My New Year's resolution is when I ask a question, somebody's going to answer. All right?
Right.
On the org chart for Santa Rosa County, the taxpayers are in the first block.
Theoretically.
As the employer, my employee, within reason, is going to answer a question that I ask them. As long as I'm not being frivolous or giving them a hard time for no good reason, I expect an answer. And but it worked out well. And this next clip, though, ladies and gentlemen, we want you to watch the clip first. Our Commissioner Gooden, after the potato was quickly handed to him, he made a few comments, and we'd like for y'all to see those. So, roll tape.
And I got assured that it's directly a commission problem. We contract with them, but I'm not sure that it's our problem necessarily. And I'm not sure we can make them comply. We can ask them to comply. I'm going to ask for an HEO opinion, because I think, as Mr. Cooley pointed out, there's certainly court opinions out there that would support that, but I think if we get your opinion that released directly to us, this can't be out of 67 counties, can't be the only one that's got that there. That'll give us a good start, and we'll have that discussion with their board and their chairman.
Now, Deborah.
He's not sure it's a county commission issue.
He's not sure that it's their problem. But, you know, Commissioner Gooden, I don't know. There's a nice group of people that work down at the landfill. Do you think it's their problem? City of Milton's got a street sweeping crew. Do you think it's their problem? Well, what about, I don't know, is it Avis Whitfield's problem? Is it roads and drainage? Is it Greg Brown's problem?
Animal control.
Is it animal control's problem? Does Mary Johnson have something to do with this? You know what, Commissioner Gooden? You're the economic chairman. And I think it's been made very clear to you. Now, you also, our Commissioner Gooden, also wanted to throw out that, he was just going to get with the Attorney General.
Right.
And get an opinion.
Right.
Well, although, ladies and gentlemen, this question might be slightly different than what we're dealing with at team.